Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy, professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's start with the numbers here in Illinois. Bring us up to date on the latest in terms of new cases and hospitalizations.
Yeah, so it looks like the increases are going down. That doesn't mean the cases are going down, but it's not increasing like it was in the last few weeks. So we had an 18% increase in the number of new cases, but that's down per week. We had a 2% increase in the number of hospitalizations, which is less than the couple weeks before, which was 12%, and before that, 38%. So those are all good things. The curve appears to be bending in Illinois. So I think what we're doing is working.
So we're hearing more about this variant Mu. Can you talk about that a little bit? And then also how we know about these new variants. Is everybody who's testing positive, are we finding out what variant they have now, or how do we know that?
Let's start with the basics. Everybody does not get tested for what variant they have. This is done, it would be impossible to do that with all these
right.
numbers. But so they do sentinel groups. They look at people from one hospital, one region, you know, one county, whatever, and in the United States per state. And they do this routine testing, and they see how much of which variant is out in that particular state. So Mu has shown up. In Illinois, there's only 18 cases. So we had 5,980 cases last Friday. You know, there's only it's a drop in the bucket. Now, in Colombia, where it was first identified, 39% of the cases are Mu. The bad thing about Mu is that it may not work very well against, the vaccines may not work that well against it. That's just, we don't know yet, but in some laboratory tests, it didn't look very good. So this is of concern, and that's why it's being monitored.
Let's move on to booster shots. What's the timeline for those?
Yeah, the booster shots, as the clip you just showed of Dr. Fauci, Pfizer and Moderna were supposed to be going in basically together to get this booster thing done simultaneously, but the Moderna data did not meet the standards that the FDA had requested. Pfizer's did. So they're going to be reviewed on the 17th of September, and they would expect approval within 3 days. So by the 20th of September, most likely, the boosters for Pfizer will be approved. Moderna now is sort of back to the drawing board. They're getting the data together and submitting it. They expect their submission and approval in October.
All right, Dr. Murphy, let's do some questions here. First one here, what's the medical community's opinion regarding treatment of COVID at the time of diagnosis? Are people still being told to go home? And if symptoms get worse, go to the hospital then?
People have to realize now that there is treatment as soon as you get diagnosed, and that's with these monoclonal antibodies that are not being used as much as they should be, and they really, really help. Even in some cases where people have been exposed, if they have an underlying immunocompromised disease. So if you have any risk factor at all for severe disease, so heart disease, lung disease, diabetes, hypertension, overweight, there's a whole list of these conditions, asthma, another one, any kind of lung disease. So if you have any of those conditions and you get diagnosed, you need to get over to the hospital or some clinic that can give you these antibodies, because they're given intravenously. You can't take it at home or in a typical doctor's office. So most of the emergency rooms are stocked with these antibodies. Get over there and take it, because it really helps.
Another question here. As an in-person teacher with 20 unvaccinated kids due to age, are there any negative health repercussions if I get my booster before the 6 to 8 months?
Well, there's no real negative repercussions. However, you don't need it. I mean, there's no difference between 4 months, 3 months, 5 months. You can wait really up to apparently 8 months before you're going to need a booster. So it's just unnecessary. You're wasting basically a shot.
All right, one more question here. Most of my family are fully vaccinated except for my younger grandchildren. Would you recommend that I get an air purifier for our indoor gatherings?
You know, this is a really good question that doesn't have an answer. You know, air purifiers across the board, they're all different. We don't know how effective they are. And so at this particular point, none of them are recommended, although they're being studied right now. The best thing is just to keep the kids a little bit away from you. They can wear masks, and you keep good ventilation in the house.
All right, Dr. Murphy, thank you. If you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, you answer them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our WGN Morning News Facebook page. We can post them there. We'll talk to him again on Friday. Thanks so much, Dr. Murphy.
Putting in the hours on Labor Day.
Right, we appreciate
Wowza.
It.
Wowza. Labor Day.